Sailorson, and we are on the Project Revolution tour right now. So I'm taking a music theory class, so is he, and an ear training class.
And I'm doing the Future of Music 101, which is good because, you know, we're kind of living the future. It's convenient in a sense, like I can have, you know, my entire course is laid out in front of me on my laptop, and whenever I find the internet, luckily we have internet on our bus here, and I can just sit and, you know, and do my course and download assignments and take quizzes right in front of me, and it's all laid out.
We do our work here. I mean, there's nowhere else to hang out. We don't really get dressing rooms. We're not like the big band on the tour. So, I mean, this is our main hangout area. So this is where we work on all of our classes, and you'll come in and like hear me like singing into my computer, and everyone's like, what are you doing, you know? But it's cool. I mean, this is our classroom.
Now, that was the main appeal for us to take the courses.
The coolest thing about online, you know, school, I've never done it before, so I was kind of, you know, it was a learning experience for me too, just because I didn't know what to expect. But the coolest thing, I think, is having the backing of your instructors. Like, the instructors are incredible, and if you have a question or you're not getting something, it's not like, you know, you don't have anyone to turn to, or, you know, you're totally stuck. It's the same as being in a classroom and having an instructor. You can talk with them, you have live chatting setups, and it's just like having, you know, it's just like being in a classroom, you know, live one-on-one with a teacher.
The coolest thing about Berklee for me was I had taken an online course at a different college before, and it was kind of like throw and go. Like, they would give you your assignment for the week, and there wouldn't be that. It would be like, read this, do this, take this quiz. And the way that Berklee set up, they take advantage of all avenues of media, whether it's video or audio, as well as articles based, you know, through the internet.
The professors are all very, very personable.
And the comments from the instructor aren't just a graded paper with red circles and you know, a red circled F, which we're used to.
Yeah.
Each part that is a little bit off, or is, you know, he'll mark exactly what you need to do and what you did wrong
and why you think you got it wrong. So they really take you through different ways of looking at it, not only, all right, this is how it is and this is correct. They give you backwards ways of looking at it that may help you, because not everyone learns the same. You know, other people learn with different types of theories and stuff. So it really helps like that, because you know, some of the things I've read before haven't made as much sense until the instructor will be like, hey, it's like this because of this, and then it's like, oh, duh, and then it clicks. My ear training 101 teacher is awesome. She like gives me vocal warm-ups before like playing and stuff. She gave me this whole accompanied, like, you know, routine to do, and it's awesome. P.S. Thanks, Roberta. It's stuff that I can actually use in my real job, in my music career now, you know what I mean? It's not just class-oriented. So, I mean, in that way, instructors are really accommodating to everyone's needs and, you know, what everyone wants to get out of the course for themselves.
I come from a complete ear-taught background. I can't even read tablature. And, you know, last night, for instance, we played up in Rochester, New York, and there was a piano there. And I found myself sitting in front of the piano and marking out major and minor scales and playing the differences and doing like the triad stuff, and I was like, that's how that works. And now I can kind of put, you know, a translation to the stuff that, in, you know, in the past, it just kind of came out of my head.
For me, in music writing and stuff, you know, you find yourself going in down the same paths you have before. And I think about the music theory class, it's about broadening the vocabulary, knowing what you can do in certain situations instead of like doing what you normally do.
We could take a music theory class at any college that offers an online course, but it's like, you can't take an in-depth ear training course as well as doing a Future of Music business course, as well as doing, you know, guitar player course, yeah. And you know, and I think that's you know, that's the definite plus for, you know, why we're going to continue to be at Berklee School of Music for as long as it takes, you know, like get as much as we can out of it while we still can, you know. Mm-hmm. And
well, as long as we're on tour, I'm definitely gonna invest in the classes, I think.